Do you have a future in your accounting or finance career, or is AI going to replace you? According to the renowned global research firm Gartner, your accounting job might look more like that of a data scientist very soon. Today, we're diving into 6 steps on how you can future-proof your accounting career and stay ahead in this AI-driven landscape. Let's go. As a management accountant in my early 40s, I'm also navigating through a massive shift in our field, and it's crucial to stay up to date on all the changes. Whether you're fresh out of college or a seasoned accounting pro, AI affects us all, and it will reshape our profession entirely. If you're feeling nervous about this change, here's what helps me most to stay on top of my game. First up, let's embrace the tech. AI and machine learning are not just buzzwords, they're our new tools. Remember when calculators revolutionized accounting? Well, AI is our new calculator, but on steroids. It's about transforming how we approach data, predictions, and problem solving. When I first started diving into AI, it felt like learning a new language. I started with beginner courses, which broke down AI concepts into digestible parts. It's crucial to start small using webinars, online courses, anything to get your foot in the door of AI literacy. By the way, if you don't know me yet, I am Nathan Liao. I help accounting and finance professionals pass the CMA exam in 16 weeks and on their first attempt. Watch until the end to discover how to download my free CMA exam cheat sheet that includes the top 9 strategies to pass the exam on the very first try. Data literacy is our new language. It's like learning to read and write all over again. But this time, it's data and code. Think of data as a vast ocean. All you see is water, and as you sail away, you have to deal with the wind and waves. As accountants, we need to be skilled navigators, capable of charting courses through these waters to uncover hidden insights. It involves mastering data extraction, data manipulation, and most importantly, data interpretation. The CMA Part 1 exam covers data analytics, and let me tell you, it's been an eye-opener to me. Understanding data trends, patterns, and anomalies has shifted how I perceive business strategies. It's not just about the numbers, it's about what they mean in the large scheme. This isn't just about knowing which buttons to press, it's understanding the why behind it. Think of it like a pilot sitting in a cockpit. He's not just pushing buttons, but he understands the art of flying the plane through turbulence, through calm or harsh weather, and the plane filled with passengers. If you don't know where to begin, start playing around with ChatGPT. That's how I got started. Write a few prompts, ask ChatGPT a few questions to get your feet wet and see its capabilities firsthand. Personally, I'm blown away by it, and I keep pushing its limits every single day. It's a learning curve, but an exciting one. Have you used ChatGPT or any other large language model? What are your thoughts? I would love to know. Let's chat in the comments. In the world of AI, continuous learning is our lifeline. Technology evolves rapidly, especially in accounting, and you would benefit by keeping pace. It's like surfing. Stay on the wave or fall off the board. There's no middle ground. I dedicate time every week to learn something new about AI in our field. It becomes a part of my routine. Also, because I'm a certified management accountant, I need to fulfill 30 hours of continuing professional education courses per year. So I look for courses on AI, data science, data analytics, and other topics related to technology. Professional certifications like the CMA or CPA are more important than ever. It's not just about having a degree, it's about being specialized and staying up to date. Consider it like someone with a black belt in martial arts. A black belt holder has specialized in martial arts through continuous and dedicated training over the years. If a black belt champion stops practicing, he or she will lose competitive edge too, and we want to stay in the game. I chose the CMA because I wanted to get my black belt in managerial accounting. Even after years in the accounting field, as a CMA, I'm still considering certifications in technology to continue with my professional training. It's about staying relevant and competitive. If you want to learn more about the CMA and pass your exam on the first try, download my free CMA exam cheat sheet. It includes the 9 best strategies to ace your exam, and the link is in the description. Being great with data is one thing, but can you tell its story? Can you effectively communicate what the data means? It's the difference between having a breakthrough and having a breakthrough that others understand and also can act upon. This means refining our ability to translate complex data into clear, actionable insights. It's like translating text in a foreign language into layman's terms. I've joined a Toastmasters club in my city in Irvine, California, to help me improve my communication and presentation skills. I highly recommend it, and this nonprofit will help you in your communication skills as well if you decide to join. Mark McDonald from Gartner said it best. 10 years from now, finance and accounting professionals will have a totally different set of skills than the experienced professional of today, and will largely look more like data scientists and systems engineers. This is our reality, and it's coming fast. As you and I adapt to this change, I encourage you not to be intimidated by age or tech savviness. Embrace AI, stay curious, and keep learning. Our accounting profession is evolving, and so are you. If you're not quite sure where to start if you decide to go for the CMA credential, watch this next video to learn the 10 steps to get certified fast.